Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In today's experiment, we shall understand about microcontroller. So first, we're gonna see the objective of experiment number 13 to understand the brief introduction to microcontrollers. So basically, we need to understand what microcontrollers are and what kind of operation they do perform and how they are more advanced and more intelligent than microprocessor. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Start with the theory. Microcontroller. A microcontroller is a small, low cost, and self-contained computer on a chip. It's a basically a computer on a chip that can be used as an embedded system. Okay. So we use in embedded system microcontroller, and microcontroller also known as the heart of embedded system, because this is the main. You can say the main unit of embedded system is microcontroller. A few microcontrollers may utilize 4-bit expression and worked at clock rate frequencies, which usually include an 8 or 16-bit microprocessor. It should be like bit microprocessor, a little measure of RAM, a small amount of RAM, programmable ROM and flash memory, parallel and serial input-output devices. Timer and signal generators, analog to digital and digital to analog conversion. Other than oscillatory circuit also present in the microcontroller. So I am gonna make you watch a picture of microcontroller. This is a kind of microcontroller which is known as Arduino Uno. It looked like this. I advise you, all of you, to purchase an Arduino Uno and make little small fancy projects related to electrical engineering with the help of this Arduino Uno. This is very helpful and very user friendly and very much cheap to buy. Next is features of microcontroller. What are the features a microcontroller hold? The basic feature is a microcontroller internally consists of all feature required for computing system without adding any external digital part in it. Okay, it doesn't need any external digital parts to carry out its function. Most of the pin can be made programmable by user. We can do programming, or we can make pin enable programming the pins of microcontroller, and we can use it either it in analog pin or either it in a digital pin. Microcontroller handle boolean function. It can easily handle boolean function, or it boolean function you also seen in DLD. What kind of boolean function you have all discussed and studied in digital logic subject. Microcontroller has many bit handling instruction user understand easily. It has high speed, low cost, small size, and it is easy to design. On-chip RAM provide better firmware security. The on-chip RAM, which is, you know, all that the microcontroller is an on-chip computer, so RAM is also provided with that computer, which is an, we can say that it's an on-chip RAM, so it provide better firmware security. Classification. Now we will see the classification of microcontroller. Microcontroller are characterized regarding bus width, on the basis of bus width, instruction set, on the basis of memory structure. For the same family, there may be different form and different sources. For example, in the above page, I have shown you the picture of Arduino Uno. The same family have other types also, Arduino Uno, Arduino Nano, etc. So also these things or these types depend upon the bus width, instruction set, memory structure. So for the same family, there may be different form with the different sources. Type of microcontroller shown in the figure, they are characterized by their bits, memory, architecture, memory and instruction set. Let's discuss briefly about it. So we will discuss about the types of microcontroller. These are the types of microcontroller. So we have 8051 series microcontroller. We have AVR, which is Advanced Virtual RISC computer. the example of this Atomega 328. We have PIC microcontroller, which is peripheral interface controller. So we have this kind of this type of microcontroller. Classification according to number of bits. So now we will discuss or see microcontroller based on the number of bits or number of architecture, based on the architecture related to number of bits. The bit in microcontroller are 8-bit, 16-bit and 32-bit. In 8-bit microcontroller, the point when the internal bus is 8-bit, then the arithmetic logic unit is performed the arithmetic and logic operation. The example of 8-bit microcontroller are Intel 8031, 8051, PIC1X, Motorola, etc. Your families. The 16-bit microcontroller perform greater precision and performance as compared to the 8-bit. For example, For example, 8-bit, there should be comma after that. For example, 8-bit microcontroller can only use 8 bits, resulting in a final range of 0 to 255 for every cycle. In contrast, 16-bit microcontroller with its 16-bit data width has a range of 0 to 65,535 for every cycle. So you can see that the range, the width of the range is increases for 16-bit, and it decreases for, and it has less range for the 8-bit microcontroller for every cycle. A longer timer, most extremely worth, can likely prove to be useful in certain application and circuits. Timer is frequently used in nowadays, and in microcontroller it enhances the efficiency of the microcontroller if the microcontroller does have the timer and counter. It can automatically operate on 2 16-bit number. Some example of 16-bit microcontroller are 16-bit MCUs are extended 8051, PIC, Intel 8096, Motorola, MC68, HC12 families. So these are the example of 16-bit microcontroller. Another type of based on the number of bit is 32-bit microcontroller uses a 32-bit instruction to perform the arithmetic and logic operation. These are used in automatically controlled devices including implantable medical devices, engine control system, office machine, appliances and other type of embedded systems. Some example, Intel Atmel 251 family, PIC 3X, etc. So this is basically the type of 32-bit instruction set. It perform these multiple function you have just discussed over here, like engine control system, office machine, appliances, etc. And these are the families of the 32-bit architecture. Now we'll discuss and study classification according to memory devices. So classification of microcontroller according to memory devices are embedded memory microcontroller, external memory microcontroller. What is embedded memory microcontroller? When an embedded system has a microcontroller unit that has all the functional block available on a chip is called embedded microcontroller. It doesn't need an external, device to help out to carry its function, and it does have all thing available on one single chip. For example, 8051 having program and data memory, IO ports, input output ports, serial communication, counter, timer and interrupts on the chip is an embedded controller. So all the things, data memory, input output ports, serial communication, timer and counter, these all things are available on a one single chip. So this is known as embedded microcontroller, and these all things are embedded on a single chip. That's why we call it embedded microcontroller. What is external? Now we are up to here. What is external memory microcontroller? When an embedded system has a microcontroller unit that has not all the function block available on a chip is called external memory microcontroller. When we need something from external source, when something is crucial, for example, when we don't have a complete IO ports, so when you need the IO ports, you have to import it from the external source. For example, 8031 has no program memory on the chip, is an external memory microcontroller. When it does have onboard chip memory, it would import the chip from the external source. So it is known as external memory microcontroller. Now, another classification based on the instruction set. We also know that we have two kind of instruction set. One is complex instruction set computer, other is reduced instruction set computer. So CISC is known as complex instruction set computer. It allows a programmer to use one instruction in place of many simpler instruction. So basically what does CISC is, it reduces the number of instructions. RISC, what is RISC does? The RISC stands for reduced instruction set computer. This type of instruction set reduces the design of the processor for industry standard. It allows each instruction to operate on any register or use any addressing mode and simultaneously access of program and data. So basically we gonna see types of microcontroller on the basis of this is two instruction set, and we all discuss that what is CISC and what is RISC. The example of CISC over here is move AX, 4, move BX, 2, add BX, AX. Simply it reduces the number of simple instruction, limited number of instruction over here. But in RISC, move AX 0, move BX 4, move CX 2, begin, add AX, BX, loop, begin. Here loop included in this kind of program, it would be a RISC instruction. Large number of instruction here, limited number of instruction. So basically this categorize two kind of instruction over here. For my other example, RISC system shorten instruction time. It reduces the instruction time because it would only operate loop. The more instruction it has to operate, it only operate the once it executed this, and the only instruction that it has to perform is the loop instruction. So RISC system shorten execution time by reducing the clock cycle per instruction. But in contrast to CISC system, shorten the execution time by reducing the number of instruction. So there is a limited number of instruction over here. We do not need to perform large number of instruction in CISC. So we can say that the RISC gives a better execution than the CISC. So there is a comparison between CISC and RISC instruction. So we also classify microcontroller based on this set of instructions. We can also classify a microcontroller based on the memory architecture as well. Memory architecture of microcontroller, we have two type of memory architecture devices of microcontroller: Harvard memory architecture microcontroller, Princeton memory architecture microcontroller. Harvard memory architecture microcontroller, the point when a microcontroller unit has a dissimilar memory address space for the program and the data memory. When there is a mismatch between the program and the data memory, that kind of microcontroller has Harvard memory architecture in the process. Princeton memory architecture microcontroller, the point when a microcontroller has common memory address for program memory and data memory. When the memory address for the program and the data memory, they both are same, they have common address. This kind of architecture, the microcontroller which possesses this kind of architecture is known as Princeton memory architecture. Now we will see the application of microcontroller. Microcontroller has many application over the electronic devices. For example, mobile phone, or for example automobiles, washing machine, in cameras, security alarms, and etc. There are hell of application of microcontrollers over electronic industry. So what about Arduino? We will learn about different component on Arduino board. I will make you study the Arduino board. Arduino is one of the kind of microcontroller. So we will need to understand Arduino because we want to make some small fancy projects on Arduino related to electrical engineering. We will study the Arduino Uno board because it is the most popular board in the Arduino board family. In addition, it is the best board to get started with electronics and coding. Some board look a bit different from the one given below, but most Arduino have majority of this component in common. So what we will gonna do now is to study the board of Arduino Uno and each and every component that the board of Arduino Uno contain. This is the picture of Arduino Uno which I have shown you on earlier page from front angle. This is the front angle and this is the front angle, and this one is the top angle of Arduino Uno board. And now we will discuss each and every component that is mentioned over here, the definition and the explanation of each and every component, so that we can understand the board on which we want to make our projects. So first one is power USB. Arduino board can be powered by using the USB cable from your computer. All you need to do is to connect your USB cable to the USB connection. To power up your board, you need to connect the cable. To power up your board, you need to connect the cable over this USB connection port from your laptop. Second is power barrel jack. Arduino board can powered directly from the AC main supply by connecting it to the barrel jack. You can also enable board, or you can also energized board, or you can also powered your board with the help of power jack over here. You can connect simply AC supply directly to the power jack over here. This is mentioned number 2. Now number 3, we will see what is number 3 over here. Voltage regulator. The function of the voltage regulator is to control the voltage given to the Arduino board and stabilize the DC voltage used by the processor and other element. You know that what is the function of voltage regulator? It will regulate your voltage to a constant level so that your voltage doesn't fluctuate and your output would not abrupt and not variate as well. So this is the third, means voltage regulator over here. Fourth one is crystal oscillator. This is crystal oscillator. What is crystal oscillator? Helps Arduino in dealing with time issues. How does Arduino calculate time? The answer is by using the crystal oscillator. The number printed on the top of the crystal oscillator is 1600H9H. It tells us that the frequency is 16,100 Hz. 16,000 Hz or 16 MHz. You can see the number written over here, which will show the frequency of the crystal oscillator of the Arduino board. So number 5th would be reset button. Number 5th would be a reset pin. Arduino reset. You can reset your Arduino board, that is start your program from the beginning. You can reset the Uno board in two ways. First, by using the reset button 17 on the board. Second, you can connect an external reset button to the Arduino pin label reset 5. There are simply two ways to reset the Arduino board, or you can you want that your program if you want your program has to run from the start again, you have to reset the Arduino Uno board. And there are two ways to reset the Arduino Uno board. One is to press button number 17, reset button, and the other one is to connect a wire on the pin 5 of the reset pin. And the number 6 is 3.3 volt pin, and number 7 is 5 volt pin. We'll discuss about these two voltages pin over here. Pins 3.3, 5, ground, and V in, yani ke voltage input voltage pin. 3.3 pin 6, pin number 6 on we can give 3.3 volt supply, 3.3 output voltage. 5 volt 7 on pin number 7 supply 5 output voltage. Most of the component use with Arduino work fine with 3.3 volt and 5 volt. Most of the component, they are relying category between 3 and 5. They mostly work with 3, mostly work with the 5 volt, and some of them are work with 3.3 volt pin. Ground is on pin number 8. You can see over here the ground on the pin number 8. So we can see that there is a ground, there are several ground points on the Arduino, any of which can be used to ground your socket. You can see there is a double ground over here. So double ground over here, one ground over here. So there is a multiple ground on the Arduino board. You can use any of which to ground your socket. And VIN, input voltage pin, pin number 9. This pin also can be used to power the Arduino board from an external power source like AC main supply. AC main power supply. So this is input voltage pin, basically pin number 9 over here. And analog pins. Now we will discuss about the analog pins. What is analog pins? What are analog pins? The Arduino Uno has 5 input pin, A0 to A5. These pins can read signal from an analog sensor like the humidity sensor or temperature sensor and convert it into the digital value that can be read by the microprocessor. So what this pin, these pins gonna do? These pins can take value from sensors which can give value in analog form, and then by the help of analog digital converter placed in Arduino Uno board, the value, analog values are then converted into digital values and then processed for the further operation. The pin, you can see there, A0 to A5. These are analog input pins. Analog in, you can see analog in written over there. Now main microcontroller. Each Arduino board has its own microcontroller. You can assume it as the brain of your board. So every board has its own microcontroller. The main IC on the Arduino is slightly different from the board to board. The microcontroller are usually of the Atmel company. You must know what IC your board has before loading up a new program from the Arduino IDE, Integrated Development Environment, which is a software compatible to the board, and which is a software which is made up for the programming of the Arduino Uno device. This information is available on the top of the IC. For more detail about the IC construction and function, you can refer to the data sheet of the specific microcontroller, specific board you are using. Now here we are using the microcontroller of Atmel company, which is, can see they get ATmega328P. It is written invertedly. You can see it by inverting your screen. The smallest it is written as ATmega328. Now we can read about ICSP pin. Mostly ICSP pin in AVR, a tiny programming header for the Arduino consisting of MOSI, MISO, SCA, SSC, K, reset, VCC and ground. It is often referred to as an SPI, a serial peripheral interface, which could be considered as an expansion of the output. Basically, it would act as a peripheral interface, and it would operate in a serial communication or serial instruction, so which would be considered as an expansion of the output. Actually, you are slaving the output devices to the master of the SPI bus. Okay, this is the ISP pin. It's mostly available in AVR, but we have an ISP pin over here also. This is over here. This is the ISP pin 12. The next one is power LED indicator. The LED should lighten up when you plug your Arduino into the power source to indicate that your board is powered up correctly. So if this light does not turn on, then there is something wrong with the connection. So the constructor of this board has installed LEDs on the board to make you sure that the board has energized. They will glow when the board will be energized or when the supplied with power. Now, transmitter and receiver LEDs. On your board, you will find two labels, transmitter and receiver, TX and RX. They appear in two places on the Arduino Uno board, first at the digital pin 01 to indicate pin responsible for serial communication, second TX RX transmitter and receiver pin LED 13. The transmitter LED flashes with different speed while sending the serial data. The speed of flashing depends upon the baud rate used by the board. RX flashes during the receiving process. So we have two LEDs over here on the board. This over digital pin, this is transmitter, transmitting pin, this is receiving pin over here. Also on pin number 13 we have an LED off. On pin number 13, we have a second transmitter and receiver LED. So transmitter LED will glow when data is to be transmitted serially, and the flashing depends upon the baud rate of the data used by the board. And receiving, or you can, receiver LED will glow or will flash during the receiving process when the data is receiving serially. Digital input and output. The Arduino Uno board has 14 input output pins, out of which 6 provide pulse width modulation output. Out of which 6 provide pulse width or pulse width modulation. These pins can be configured to work as input digital pin to read logic values 0 or 1, or as digital output pins to drive different module like LEDs, like relays, etc. The pin label like this label can be used to generate pulse width modulation signals. This is from pin 0 to 13. Total are there 14. So this is known as digital pin. You can see that the digital written over here, and PWM with sign of this. All the pins with sign of this, like 3, 5, 6, 9, 10, and 11, these are pulse width modulation pins. AREF stands for analog reference. It is sometimes used to set an external reference voltage between 0 to 5 volt as an upper limit for the analog input pin. So you can see analog reference over here. This is analog reference over here. It will set the voltage between 0 to 5 volt. So we have discussed all the part, all the function of Arduino Uno board. Hopefully you can now able to use Arduino board, and can you, further I will make you teach about the IED, integrated development environment, which is a software compatible with the Arduino board, to do programming on the software and to make small little projects in the electronic that is used in home, that is used in industry, or that is used in basically in the domain of electronics. So I can conclude this lab over here. Like in this lab we have learned about brief description of microcontroller and their feature and types. We have also learned about the complete feature or pin configuration of Arduino Uno and how to upload the code for the Arduino Uno. We will discuss this in next lab. This we will discuss in next lab. All the feature of Arduino Uno. So, good luck to you guys. Hopefully, this would be an interesting lab. First of all, in previous lab, we discussed about microprocessor. In today's lab, we discuss about the microcontroller. What are the microcontrollers? How they advance, features, the classification based on the bits, based on the architecture, based on the memory, based on the set of instruction. Then I make you study about the Arduino, one of the kind of a microcontroller. Then I make you understand about that board of the Arduino and the feature, the type of facilities we have provided on the board, and we discuss each and every facility provided on the board in very depth and detail. Hopefully this would be a good session for you guys. And if you have any query, any question related to this tab, we will surely discuss in the live session tomorrow, inshallah. Okay, good luck guys. Allah Hafiz.